Let's now talk to the spokesperson of the Philippine Health Department and Undersecretary for Health Regulation, Eric Domingo, to tell us more about the government's efforts in dealing with the alleged mysterious disease from China. Now, Undersecretary Domingo is also supervising the Bureau of Quarantine. Thanks a lot for your time, Undersecretary.
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. Good afternoon to everybody.
All right. Tell us a bit about what is known so far about this disease. How similar and how different is it from SARS as we know it?
Well, right now, all of the cases that have been tested, the ones that have been detected in China, all 44 cases tested negative for ABS-CBN flu. Apparently, it's a different breed. It's a different strain of virus, which so far is not yet identified. It seems a little less virulent. There have been no mortality so far. And so far, we have not documented, either China or WHO, have not documented any human-to-human transmission. We're really just being very, very careful right now here in the Philippines. That's why we put our Bureau of Quarantine on alert. In terms of fever and flu, we just have to take a good look and measure and see if we have to quarantine them.
Basically, the symptoms to look out for are fever, flu, and coughing. Am I correct?
Yes. You know, it's like a regular flu. It's a feeling of heaviness, and then you have your cough, your cold, maybe a headache, and a fever. So it's very similar to any kind of flu. However, this one, they just found it. There was a clustering in this province in China, and all of the people who had it, when they were tested, did not test positive for any regular flu virus. So it's something new. And they all know that there's this exposure or a visit to a certain market in China that they are now investigating.
All right. Can a flu shot help, especially those Filipinos traveling to and from China?
Well, no, a flu shot will help you on the against the virus strain that the flu shot is created for, which is probably not this virus. Because this virus, like I said, until now has not been identified. So there's no flu shot against it, but it will protect you from the currently circulating flu virus.
Meantime, concerns are high. What kind of monitoring system is the Philippines implementing to make sure cases of this disease are tracked down before they even enter the country?
Oh, all of our ports of entry have our quarantine officers. I don't know if you've noticed, after you get down the tube, there's this camera pointed at you, and we have three or four officers there looking at everybody, scanning thermally, anybody have any fever. However, maybe the next few days we'll be just taking a closer look at people coming in and getting off flights from China and Hong Kong.
All right, moving on. What is your advice to the general public? How do people guard or protect themselves against the disease?
Well, it's really proper hygiene. You know, all respiratory tract infections can be prevented by proper hygiene. Frequent hand washing, covering your mouth and your nose, especially if you have an infection, so as not to spread it. And if we are in a crowded place, wearing a mask would definitely protect us from this.
And what's going to happen if you monitor a case in the Philippines?
We have that system ready ever since that SARS outbreak a few years ago. So we have our quarantine office. We detect, for example, somebody with fever coming from China, then they will ask them to step aside, do an interview, a physical examination, and if we think that there's some risk, then we have to admit them to our quarantine hospital.
Yes, on that note, thanks a lot, Undersecretary Eric Domingo. Nice to have you on the show.